Hey guys, welcome back. In this lesson, we'll be taking a look at interacting with stored procedures using Entity Framework Core. Now, the case study for why you would need to interact with a stored procedure comes from the fact that maybe you're dealing with legacy systems where a lot of the logic is in stored procedures in the database. So in the rebuild, you don't want to double the work, rewrite them, you just reuse them. So in that situation, you probably need to just know how to make stored procedure calls from EF Core. So I have a very simple one that I've constructed for the context of our database, where I just have SP get team coach, and it gets a team ID, and then it returns from the everything from the coaches table. Now remember that when we're dealing with raw SQL, we have to return everything that corresponds with the matching entity type. All right, so you can't just say name. You have to, or if you're going to list them out, you have to list them out in the order of the column names, with the same column names, no aliases and anything. So like we did with our views and functions, the first thing that we're going to do is create a new migration. I added a migration saying added SP get coach name. I messed up the name of the migration, but we'll continue. And then I put in the migration builder to create the procedure and similarly to drop afterwards. So you can go ahead and do the migration and do those steps. And then we can just update our database. And then that allows us to start interacting with our stored procedure. Now in our program.cs file, I've already gone ahead and written some sample code, and the new method that we're working with is exec stored procedure. So in exec stored procedure, I just hard coded a team ID, and then I'm going to pass it into the raw SQL statement and await the result. Now let's take a look at the syntax. I will say await context.coaches.from SQL raw, and then I call my execution to get me SP get team coach, and then I have a placeholder. Now note that I'm using from SQL raw. In the previous lesson, I stopped short of condemning it, saying that it was bad because it opens you up for SQL injection. The reality is that it's based on how you use it. So I showed you the bad way to use it initially, where I used an interpolated string and passed the value directly in. So all of this got translated into literal SQL, which is the worst thing that you can have between user input and going to the database. Parameterization is always best, hence our preference for the interpolated. But then let's take a step back and not condemn from SQL raw too much, because if we take a look at its overload, it really says give me the string SQL and then give me a list of parameters. So that is exactly what we've done here. I say exec dbo.sp get team coach, and then I use a placeholder, and then after that placeholder or after that string, I have now included the parameter. So when you do it in this manner, it will actually handle the parameterization for you, just the same way that we saw from SQL interpolated do it. So it's not the worst method, and it's not completely useless, because you probably left the last lesson wondering, so why did they put it if it's so dangerous? There's a good way to use it and there's a bad way to use it. So I showed you the bad way. Here is the better or more recommended way to use it. So let us take a look at that. Now, when we take a look at what we get back, we see that our query is being generated and parameterized, like we said or expected it to be. So there it is, taking that parameter of 3, executing the stored procedure, and then our result is Jose Mourinho's information as the team coach for team with the ID 3. So that is how you can execute a stored procedure. And pretty much that's how we execute commands against a database that are, well, query commands. We're asking the database for something and we see it getting returned. So in that situation, that's why we have to execute these raw SQL commands against a table in each situation. Now, what happens when we need to execute a stored procedure that is not associated with a table, or query something that's not directly associated with any entity type? So we need raw SQL against some object that is not associated with an entity type. That's what we're going to look at in our next lesson.